Real friends talk about all the fucked up nights. The nights that weren't even funny for like 3 years after the shit went down. That's why everyone in here has a friend that's a complete social liability. Those friends you can't invite to important shit, but you'll go meet them at a bar sometime so they can make you feel better about yourself. Because you know no matter how bad you fuck up in life, they will fuck up 10 times worse. They're that friend that all their stories end with, and then the cops were tasering me. That's the male version. Women have that friend, but her stories end more like, yeah, I broke into his house, so what? I didn't have to get shit back. I just wanted to see what he was up to. Everybody's got a fucked up friend, man. My grandpa had a fucked up friend. My grandpa had a friend named Dirt. And I know that's not his real name. But normally when you got a fucked up nickname like Dirt or Spooge, like, and you get introduced to your friend's grandson, like, hey, Dirt, this is my grandson, Chris. Chris, Dirt. That's normally when a grown-ass man should say some shit, like, hey, real name's Larry. Friends call me Dirt. Dirt didn't fucking say that, okay? Dirt just said name's Dirt. Pleasure. And then he started telling stories. Apparently, the weekend before I met Dirt, he had been in Las Vegas for a bachelor party. And as him and a couple of his buddies were walking down the Las Vegas Strip, a gentleman popped out of an alley and said, hey, fellas, who wants a blowjob? $15. Now, Dirt's friends, like most of us, were like, we're good on that. But Dirt, who's a bargain hunter, was like, can you break a 20? And he could, he's a businessman. So Dirt's friends are like, hey man, you do you. We're gonna go to the next casino. You come find us when you're done. Dirt shows up a weird blowjob later. Says, hey fellas, thanks for hanging out waiting for me. First round's on me. And that's when he reaches behind him to grab his wallet. And that's when he discovers that while the guy was blowing him, he also took his wallet. Ha 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 ha. Ha ha ha. Listen, not the greatest story. I know that. I'm just trying to illustrate why we all have friends like Dirt. Because when your friend like Dirt tells a story like that, all of a sudden you missing a car payment last month, not that big of a fucking deal, is it? Sure, the credit company keeps calling you, but Dirt might have AIDS. And he paid $15 to get it. Could you imagine finding out you have AIDS and then realizing you paid $15 for it? Like you can't even budget yourself the Sarah McLachlan CD to cry yourself to sleep. In the home of the angels, may you forever some company. See? See? Now we're all thinking about dead puppies. Have you seen the Sarah McLachlan sad puppy commercial? That's the most fucked up commercial on television. First off, they only show it at 1 o'clock in the morning. Hey, Sarah McLachlan, if I'm watching TV at 1 in the morning, I'm already sad. And now you're just gonna show me videos of sad puppies in a cage after sad puppies in a cage? Meanwhile, she's all, you know how. And that commercial's been on for 2 years. You know those dogs are dead by now. God damn it, Sarah McLachlan. I don't have dead dog money. My apartment doesn't even allow live dogs. Now you're kidding me up for dead. Go fuck yourself, Sarah McLachlan. That joke gets weird. That joke gets super weird. You're like, is he singing Angel? That's a good song. They don't need to play that shit on the radio anymore. All right, that's a fucked up song to play on the radio. That song is for crying alone and funerals. That's the only time that song needs to be played. No one wants to hear that shit on the way to work. Like 8:30 in the morning on a Tuesday, you're just trying to get to work. Fuck you, Jack FM. What's the matter, Dave? Fucking they played Angel on the way to work, and now I need to call my mom.